Welcome back, friends. So last night, as you can see, we got a little dusting of snow. Not a whole lot, just a little bit. But actually, the skies are pretty blue, so I think it's going to be a pretty nice day, just a little chilly. However, a few days ago, I went to go ahead and start the Jeep, and I had a dead battery. And while pulling out the battery, I noticed that the battery was really loose. So I undid the battery clamp to take a look, and the battery clamp is in a U shape, and it's pretty much shot. So that got me thinking, what affordable battery clamps are out there, and what's kind of the best option if you're looking to upgrade or just replace? I have a few options here. I don't have everything. I bought these with my own money, so we're going to take a look at them, and then you can decide what's the best option. And I'm going to tell you what I kind of think is the best option. Hint, I don't like these stock clamps anymore. I know a few people who've used them, and they seem to all wear out. Anyway, let's take a look at what we have. Your first option is this little guy. Now, basically, this is going to come on your like 2005 and up Jeeps. It's just a little wedge. Most of your newer vehicles are going to have this too. The problem I have with these things is that they tend to banana like this over time. Even if you're ginger on it like I was, I never really over-torqued it or anything. What happens is they start to crack right here. They start to bend. And then from there, you're on borrowed time with these things. And so that's what's going on with this one. Now, you could replace them if you want the factory one. You're probably looking about $30 to $40. If you want something like something from Dorman, probably about $10, but how long are they gonna last? I'm not exactly sure. So let's move on to your second option. As far as cheaper options go, this is your second option. So you're gonna get one of these bars from Amazon, most likely. That's where I got this one. And essentially, this is just a hole down that goes over the top of the battery and clamps to your battery plate. I have a problem with this. One, I don't like that it's not coated because it doesn't give as much grip on the battery. And so unless you have one of these milled specifically for the width of your battery, most of these are gonna be generic, they're really not gonna hold that well. There's gonna be quite a bit of slop in here, and you're really gonna have to crank the battery, the bolts down, the J-bolts, to get them tight enough to stop the battery from moving. And then there becomes a question is like, how much is too much? And the problem is the J-bolts too. Now, this is just the kit I bought, but most Universal's kits are like this. Essentially, you're gonna get these hokey rubber washers. That's supposed to give it some spring, some tension. You get these little chintzy J-bolts, and then you're gonna get wing nuts. The problem with this kit is, one, these are not very strong. They're pretty thin. The shape of the hook is not really conducive to clamping onto your battery tray. And then also, you get wing nuts, which is not very fun. You're also gonna have to cut these down. They're way too tall. Granted, they're universal, so you're gonna have to modify them a little bit, but I just think for the money, this is not the best way to go. Now, in my opinion, the best way to go is to just get one of these. This is the late model, or the early model, I mean, factory hold-down clamp for the TJ. You have a nice stout metal bar here. These things are also rubber-coated, so you're gonna have lots of grip. The J-bolts are much, much beefier, and the shape of them is nicer too. It means you're just gonna bend your battery tray less with one of these setups. And I think they're better than going from some like crazy $200 battery mount. This is just simple, it works, it's worked for a long time, and I don't think anyone really has a problem with these. The only issue, the two issues you have, is if you have a later model TJ, you're gonna have to put a different battery tray in because there's simply not a spot for these to clamp to. The other problem is you can't really buy these new, so you're gonna have to buy them used. I got this one off eBay, there's a seller on there that sells a ton of them. I'll put a link in the description for all these parts in case you want anything, but yeah, I think this is the best way to go. This was like $29 shipped, so this is not bad. Okay, so those are the style of clamps. Now, let's go ahead and get it installed. There's one thing you have to be very careful of when installing this in your Jeep, specifically on a TJ. So let's take a look. So like I mentioned before, to use these type of hold downs we're gonna use, we have to replace the battery tray. This should take a half inch socket to pull these guys out, so we're just gonna do this. Now, one thing I should mention, see this little hole right here and how it's empty on my Jeep? This isn't always the case. This is a battery temperature sensor. Now, some TJs have them, some don't. You'll just have to check if yours does. There's really no rhyme or reason or way to figure out which Jeeps have them, which Jeeps don't. You're just gonna have to check your own. If you do have this though, you wanna be careful and make sure you use it so you don't throw a check engine light or anything. Could have repercussions. I'm not sure what happens if you disconnect it, but you'll wanna make sure you have that in there if your Jeep comes with it. So that's something to pay attention to. now that we've got this out, let's take a look at the difference in the battery trays, just so you can see. So there is the stock battery tray if you have a 2005 or up TJ. Essentially, and it's a battery tray, there's not really a whole lot to talk about. You have your mounting holes. There's the hole I was talking about for your temperature sensor if you have one. You have this little wedge over here, essentially. That's the lip your battery is going to sit under. And then you have your wedge that bolts in right there. Essentially, you can actually see the markings where the metal is shiny, where my battery has slid back and forth. So this wedge just doesn't work anymore. That's the thing. I probably could hammer this in and tighten it up and get a new wedge, and that might work, but I don't know. I decided just to replace it just because I think it's going to be better. I think it's better to have something going over the top of the battery than a little plastic wedge. So let's take a look at the new one. And here's the new one. So right off the bat, you'll see the shape is a little bit different, but all the mounting holes align, so you won't have that problem. If you have the temperature sensor, there's the hole for it, so you're good there. But the biggest thing is that you have these holes here, which you need for the mounting, the clamp itself, the J-hooks to actually go in there and grab. And the reason these are slotted like this is so you can actually slip the J-hook in and then twist. And that's what's really nice about the factory one is you can loosen them, twist the J-hooks, and just slip the whole bar out through here. You don't have to do any kind of funkiness like the universal kits. You don't do any kind of funkiness to get everything out. It's just going to be simple. So let's go ahead and get this installed. Let's get this in here. I always recommend putting a little bit of anti-seize on bolts that you pull out. Just makes it easier, makes it so they don't rust later on, especially if you live in a salt area. That way, if I ever go to pull this out in another 10 years, I can get it out and we'll be rusted solid. Okay, let's get the battery in. Oh, yeah, that's definitely not going anywhere. Perfect, just what we want. Okay, let's get the battery connected now. Okay, we're just tightening all these connections up. I had to actually go and reorganize these wires to make sure they, to make it actually fit. What I really need to do is come in here one day and just redo this whole wiring, but that's a different project for a different time for right now. Okay, we're all tightened down and good to go. Battery's nice and secure, so much better than that wedge. We have one last thing to do, and that's battery terminal protecting spray. I put this on every vehicle I own or if I help anyone out. It just, you know, it helps protect these terminals. This is an AGM battery, so really you shouldn't have any corrosion, but if there is any, it'll just help protect it and keep everything nice so when I come back to it in a few years or if I do anything, I know that I don't have to clean up corrosion. So, okay. There we go. I think we're done. All right, let's see if this thing starts. It's been a few days. Yeah, that started right up. All right, so the Jeep starts and runs. That's always a good sign we did something right. But honestly, I think this clamp is just, it's the best method out there. If you already have an early TJ, I don't think there's any reason to consider upgrading to anything fancy. This holds it really tight. It's gonna last you forever. And actually it's a plus if you have an older Jeep or something with like the wedge style, a hold down that I showed you, get rid of that and go to this. I think this is gonna be much better. It should just last forever, really, unless you corrode the junk out of the metal or you bend it. But even if you do bend it, you can always straighten it back out. So there's a plus there. I just think this is the best way to go if you're having a problem with the battery being held down like I did. With that, if you are trying to find any of these parts, I'll leave links in the description below so you can take a look, and then you'll be able to decide which route you want to go. I really don't recommend the Amazon route. The yellow battery bar that I showed you earlier, that little hold down. I don't recommend that, but you can always go to that. It might work for you. It just it didn't work for me, and I don't recommend it. So with that, though, thank you for watching. We'll see you in the next video.